Hello student, myself Nimesh Prabhakar. Welcome to Antenna and Propagation lecture series. In the chapter of Antenna Array, we discuss the different types of array, like different condition for the array. Now, continue this chapter. In this chapter, first we discuss about the Hassan, Woodyard and Fire array. Then second one, we discuss about the pattern multiplication. And last topic we discuss is the binomial array. So now we start with the Hassan, Woodyard and Fire array. One of the shortcoming, or we can say the disadvantage of and Fire array is they are relatively broad SPBW as compared to broadside array. Hence directivity is low. So this is the disadvantage of Endfire array. So here the disadvantage is directivity is low in the Endfire array. Maximum radiation can be obtained along the axis of uniform Endfire array if the progressive phase shift alpha between the element is given by alpha is equals to plus or minus beta d minus beta d for the maximum in the phi is equals to 0 direction and alpha is equals to plus beta d for the maximum in the phi is equals to 180 degree. We know that the maximum direction for the end phi array is in the phi is equals to 0 and the phi is equals to 180 degree. Now to enhance the directivity of end phi array, Hassan and Woodyard produce or propose the phase shift of an ordinary Endfire array should be, that means alpha value should be minus beta d plus 2.94 upon n. So this is nothing but we can say the for the approximately minus beta d plus pi by n for maximum in phi equals to 90, phi equals to 0 degree. And same as for the phi equals to 180 degree, the condition is equals to plus beta d plus pi by n for the phi equals to 180 degree. So to increase the directivity of the end phi array, the Hassan and Woodyard, they have changed the equation for the alpha or the condition for the alpha. So we can increase the directivity of the Endfire array. So the enhanced directivity due to Hassan-Woodyard condition can be realized by using previous equation along with assumption for the value given as below, like for the maximum radiation along the phi equals to 0 degree, the condition psi is equals to beta d cos phi plus alpha phi equals to 0 is equal to pi by n. And the psi equals to beta d cos phi plus alpha phi equals to 180 degree, the value is the pi. For the maximum radiation angle phi equals to 180 degree, the condition for the psi is equals to beta d cos phi plus alpha for phi equals to 180 degree is equals to pi by n. And psi equals to beta d cos phi plus alpha phi equals to 0 is equals to pi. So this is the condition for the directivity of the Hassan-Woodyard Endfire array. Now we discuss about the directivity. So the equation for the Hassan-Woodyard Endfire array directivity is d is equals to 1.7894 n into l by lambda. Now in the case l is very large as compared to d, so we can write d is equals to 1.79789 for l by lambda, where the L is the total length of the array, D is indicate the spacing between the element, N is the number of element in the array. So, and here the lambda is nothing but the wavelength. So this is the directivity equation for the Hassan-Woodyard Endfire array. Now we discuss about the pattern multiplication. Now, principle of pattern multiplication state that the radiation pattern of any array is the product of the pattern of the individual antenna with the array pattern. So advantage of method of multiplication is it helps to sketch the radiation pattern of array antenna rapidly from the simple product of element pattern and the array pattern. So by using this pattern multiplication concept, we can produce the radiation pattern in our desired direction. So to understand this, now we consider four element array of equal space identical antenna as shown in this figure. So here we consider the four element. Let us the spacing between these two element is a d is equal to lambda by 2. The radiation pattern of antenna 1 and 2 treat to be operating as a single unit is as shown in the figure. Like this is the radiation pattern for the element 1 and 2. Similarly, radiation pattern of the antenna 3 and 4 treat to be operate as a single unit is again as shown in the figure. So we know that this is the pattern multiplication. So the final pattern for the element 1 and 2 is like this, and for the 3 and 4 is also like this. Now instead of considering two separate element 1 and 2, we can replace it by single antenna located at the point midway between the them d by 2 as shown in the figure. So here we have put this element like this. Instead of this two element, we have put one separate element here, and same as from that side, instead of two element, we have put this element here. But this the distance between these two element is the lambda. Here the distance between the element is the lambda by 2, but here this element distance is the lambda. Similarly, we replace the element 3 and 4 by the single element. So now both the antenna have bidirectional pattern. So the figure 8 pattern space distance lambda apart from each other feed with equal current in phase as shown in the figure. So this is the pattern for the when we place two element at a distance at the lambda. So we get this type of this radiation pattern. So now we understand pattern multiplication. So resultant radiation pattern. Now the resultant radiation pattern of the four element array can be obtained as the multiplication of the pattern as shown in the figure. So first one, this 8 figure pattern is indicate the pattern for the two element, for the distance between them is the lambda by 2. And the second one pattern is for the distance between the two element is the lambda. So finally we get this pattern. Now we discuss about the binomial array. In case of uniform linear array, to increase directivity, it is necessary to increase the array length. Okay? Because if we want to increase the directivity, we have to increase the array length. Then we increase the directivity. But due to this, the secondary or minor loops are observed in the overall pattern. So when we increase the number of element, so when we increase the n, then due to that, the minor loops are present in the radiation pattern. In some application, it is need to have a pattern with single main loop with no minor loop. So in a different like application, we require the radiation pattern without the minor loop. So in such case, binomial array is most preferred. Now we understand how it increases the directivity without increasing the side loops. The binomial array with a spacing between two adjacent elements equal to or less than lambda by 2 produce a pattern without a side loops A binaural array is non-uniform amplitude array. The amplitude of the element in the binaural array are arranged such that there are no side loops in the resultant. Now we understand this concept. Let us consider that the array consists of two identical sources with equal in phase excitation with distance d between two elements as shown in this figure. So here this is the 1 and 2. There are the two elements and the distance between two is the d. For this array, the normalized field pattern is given by En is equals to cos pi by d cos theta. Now we discuss about the radiation pattern. So with d is equals to lambda by 2, it is observed that the pattern has no side loop and it is the figure of 8 shape pattern. Similarly, with d is equals to lambda, when the distance is changed in the lambda, the pattern is obtained is shown is like this, like a without side loop. Radiation pattern for the d is equals to lambda, and this is the radiation pattern for the d is equals to lambda by 2. Now here, suppose to increase the directivity, array length is increased. So here, instead of 2, we have put the 4 element. So let us now consider that instead of the 2 element, the array consists of 4 element, space lambda by 2 apart as shown in the figure. So now here we want to increase the directivity. So we increase the number of elements. So we have put 4 element with the spacing is the lambda by 2. Note that the A and B represent each a group of two element separate by distance lambda by 2. So this A, this B and opposite side this A is indicate the group of the 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And these two groups are separate by the distance lambda. That means A and B is distance between them is the lambda. So the radiation pattern, the unit pattern of the element with the separate lambda by 2 is the figure 8. We know that in the pattern multiplication, same as the distance between the two is the lambda. So we get the this pattern. This is the group pattern. So the resultant pattern or the by the pattern multiplication principle, we get this type of pattern. But here we note that this pattern has the side loops. Here we can see 1, 2, 3 and 4 side loops are present. So now by using the binomial concept, we can reduce these side loops. Now we understand how it works. So to reduce or eliminate the completely, we should have group pattern also of a figure 8 pattern, which is possible only when the separation between the group element is less than or equal to lambda by 2. When the separation between these two elements is lambda, then the side loops is generated. But when we put this group element like A and B at the distance like this, at the lambda by 2, the radiation pattern, like the resultant pattern, is not give the side loops. So to achieve this, let us move the group B towards group A, the element 3 and 4 towards the element 1 and 2, till distance of separation is the lambda by 2. When group B is at the distance lambda by 2 from A, we observe that the element 2 and 3 are overlapped or coinciding as shown in the figure. So we can see this is two element 2 and 3 are overlooked here at this. And this is the opposite side element 1. This is the 2 and 3 and this is the 4. And these two, like A and B, have become the lambda by 2 distance. So now we discuss about the radiation pattern. So now as a two group A and B are also separate by the distance lambda by 2, and the group pattern is also at the distance of the lambda by 2. So we get these two lambda by, this is the first one is the lambda by 2 pattern and second one is the group pattern. So finally we get the resultant pattern is the figure 8 square pattern, as it is the product of two figure 8. So that's why here we can increase the directivity without any side loop. So this is the concept of the binomial array. Using the equation number 1, the electric field of two element with the distance of separation d is equal to lambda by 2 is given by En equals to cos. Instead of the d, we have write just the lambda by 2. So we get the cos pi by 2 cos theta. Thus, for the four element array, the resultant element electric field is given by En is equal to En unit pattern into group pattern. That means cos pi by 2 cos theta into cos pi by 2 cos theta. So we get the unit pattern for the resultant pattern as a En, Ern is equal to cos square pi by 2 cos theta. Now, three element non-uniform array. So here we consider a three element with a non-uniform array. To obtain a three element non-uniform array, two element uniform array are overlapped as shown in this figure. Like the 1 and 2 and 3 and 4, this 2 is the overlap. So they can be replaced by the single element carrying 2i, that means the current is become the magnitude of the 2, which is 2 times the current the i in the outer element as shown in the figure. So instead of the 2 and 3 separate current, we have given the current as a 2i magnitude. The resultant pattern is the figure 8 square pattern as shown in the figure. So we get the 8 figure resultant pattern as we discussed the previous slide. As the current ratio of the element, we can write as 1 gem 2 gem 1. Same as now we discussed about the 4 element non-uniform array. To obtain the 4 element non-uniform array, 2-3 elements non-uniform array are overlapped as shown in the figure. Like a 4 element, we get this. This is the overlap figure. So, in this case, element 2 of group A coincide with the element 1 of the group B, while element 3 of group A with element 2 of group B. So they can be replaced by a single element carrying current 3i, each as shown in the figure. So the ratio, the resultant pattern is a product of the unit pattern and group pattern. So for the ratio of the current, we can write 1 gem, 3 gem, 3 gem, 1. So the resultant pattern is obtained is called a figure 8 club pattern. So we can write for the 4 element, the equation become the cos square pi by 2 cos theta, cos pi by 2 cos theta, and cos pi by 2 cos theta. So we get the cos cube pi by 2 cos theta. So now here we talk about the 2 element, 3 element. Now if we have the n element, so by following above procedure, we can achieve the required directivity using n element where the current amplitude of the element are arranged according to the coefficient of the binomial series. So the coefficient of the binomial series can easily be arranged using this Pascal triangle as shown in the figure. So the ratio we can arrange of the current by using this Pascal triangle. What the n equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 7. So the resultant we can write as a En is equal to cos n minus 1 pi by 2 cos theta. And here the n is indicated number of element in the array. So in this lecture, first we discuss about the Hassan-Woodyard end file array. Then we discuss about the pattern multiplication. And last we discuss about the binomial array. Thank you.